स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू।
एक्सरसाइज नंबर 13। मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन सर, आई एम वेरी ग्लैड दैट यू हैव एट लीस्ट गिवन मी 5 minutes टू स्पीक ऑन द वर्किंग ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स। In fact, the Ministry of Commerce is concerned not only with commerce but also with supply and cooperation. I wanted to say a few words on cooperation, but I was told that I am not allowed to say anything as far as cooperation is concerned. My honorable friend is a dynamic minister, and I personally feel that I should point out to him 2 things particularly in regard to the entire working of the textile mills. The minister is also a trade union leader, having led so many labor agitations in the country. He knows the problems of the textile mills. There are so many sick textile mills in the country, and the National Textile Corporation was set up with this end in view, that those sick units should be nationalized and taken over by government. The result of this policy is, as the honorable member who just preceded me said, that every year ₹6 crores worth of loss is being incurred by government. It was done with a view to seeing that the labor was not thrown out of jobs and safeguarding the interests of the workers. Otherwise, the private mill owners used to say, on one pretext or another, that their mills were not working properly. They had invested in machinery whatever money they could get. They had gained so much profits out of these mills, and therefore they wanted to close these mills and throw their workers out of jobs. Government, however, thought it proper to take these sick mills over and continue these workers in their jobs. So they are incurring losses. My only plea to the honorable minister is that instead of investing money in the modernization of these textile mills, the government should set up new textile mills in the public sector wherever raw cotton is being produced, so that the farmers will also get remunerative prices, the workers will also get jobs, and the industry will get decentralized instead of being centralized in places like Bombay and Ahmedabad. Whenever these mills are closed by the private textile mill owners, so many agitations and other things take place in the cities and they create law and order problems. Therefore, this matter should be taken as a particular case by the Honorable Minister. There is one more point regarding the production of control cloth about which so many honorable members have spoken. I would like to point out to Honorable Minister one particular thing. Here also, they were required to produce a particular quantity of cloth, but most of the private mill owners never produced this control cloth, and on the contrary, they manufactured other types of cloth for export or other purposes and taking undue advantage of rising prices in the domestic market, they got more money. They were prepared even to pay fine to the government. Even the fine has not been recovered from the textile mills, and in the meantime, these textile mills have been declared sick and government had to pay something like 6 crores of rupees to them. All such unscrupulous things indulged in by the private textile mill owners should be dealt with severely. I do not know why it is not being done, and also I do not know why the Honorable Minister, who is a champion of nationalization, is not coming forward with legislation for nationalizing all these textile mills so that he can give protection to the workers and production is according to the requirements for export purposes as well as domestic purposes. Instead of giving a free hand to the private trade and these textile mill owners, the minister may consider this point. Sir, another point is with regard to power looms. The power loom sector also is a very important sector. 1 million workers are engaged in this sector, and if yarn is not made available in time, these workers will be thrown out of employment and the power loom will be closed. So many times it has happened. When we see the policy of the government of India on this, it is somewhat strange. Of course, I am not here to speak on the finance bill, but they are levying so much excise duty from them and they cannot compete with the composite mills. In the case of yarn particularly, well, in time through the Apex cooperative of the handloom cooperatives, just as he has made this arrangement for handlooms, he can also come forward to make such an arrangement for the power looms also. As far as production of agricultural commodities which are meant for export is concerned, I find, for instance, that export of sugar and tobacco has fallen. I humbly request the Honorable Minister to boost export by a method which does not harm the people. In the present day world of interdependence, it is essential to develop trade with outside world for self-reliance of the economy. Thank you.